And welcome back to this series, Anthropology and Us, trying to think about ways that we can actually apply the ideas that we learn in the anthropology class to our everyday lives to make things more meaningful and not just something that we digest from a book and then maybe put aside after we finish this class. This next concept is really key and foundational. I sometimes say like this is the equivalent of gravity in a physics class or a certain maybe key equation in a mathematics class. This is the concept of culture. And culture is something that anthropologists talk about, yet will fully encourage us to think about critically. For one reason, we often say that we can't come up with one definition of culture. I'll talk about a book that was written years ago that expressed the idea of all the different ideals and definitions and foundations of culture. And the book was over 400 pages long. So that gives you a sense of how tricky it is to consider and discuss a lot of these things, like these key concepts we're talking about in anthropology. So as we think about culture, one way to approach it is how do we understand culture? How do we understand its connection to our lives? Maybe we're part of certain advocacy groups, or we have a certain style of music, or a taste in art, or food, or fashion that we like, that we feel falls outside the mainstream. Does that put us in what anthropologists and sociologists call a subculture? We're going to talk about some of those notions as well today. Anthropology is the study of humanity, and at the heart of this field is the study of culture. Culture is a crucial concept in anthropology because it helps us understand how people make sense of the world and how they interact with each other. Culture encompasses everything from the food we eat to the stories that we tell, to the way that we organize our social, economic, and religious systems. It's the shared beliefs, values, and practices that shape our lives and make us who we are. As anthropologists, we study culture in all its diversity, seeking to understand how different cultures have developed over time and how they continue to change and evolve today. We do this through a variety of methods, from ethnography to participant observation, interviews, and even archival research. So I did want to mention to you that there's a book out there by Krober and Kluckhohn that is a book really just about the definitions of culture. And this book is hundreds of pages long, and I think that gives us some insights that culture is something that anthropologists haven't agreed on. So this gives you a little more understanding of why culture is both an important concept in anthropology and one that is contested or challenged quite vigorously by cultural anthropologists. One of the reasons that culture is so important in anthropology is because it helps us see the world from different perspectives. By studying different cultures, we can gain a deeper appreciation for the diversity of human experience and learn to question our own assumptions and biases. Culture is also important in anthropology because it helps us understand how people create meaning and find purpose in their lives. Cultural practices, from religious rituals to artistic expressions, can be powerful sources of meaning and identity for individuals and communities. In short, culture is at the heart of anthropology because it helps us understand what it means to be human. By studying culture, we may gain a deeper appreciation for the diversity of human experience, challenge our own assumptions, and trace the connections between different societies, cultures, and historical periods. And so that will be it today here talking in our Anthropology and Us segment about culture. As I mentioned in this video, it's a foundational concept. I encourage you to take a critical look at it, and by all means, ask some questions about how you relate to this idea of culture. Be critical of it. Have some conversations with yourself, with your classmates, with others outside the class, and really consider the role that culture plays in your lives. I think it's one of the ways that you can really engage with the world is through that sort of lens of curiosity and sometimes strangeness. We talk about that dichotomy of the familiar and the strange with culture. And so it's a great opportunity to really think about all these concepts as we approach anthropology this quarter. So thanks for listening, and I'll have more videos in this series.